A Boeing foundation wall is a big deal. How do you straighten it?
We have a foundation wall here that's actually falling inwards towards the house.
We've got a deflection of about 4.5 to 5 inches, which is over half the width of the wall that's no longer structurally stable.
Right under this, we have a good void. This one sank into the void.
Austin, take us through how we're gonna fix this wall.
We are going to use wall plates.
A plate on the inside of the wall, a plate in the yard, and a threaded rod between them. And we're gonna use that rod and the anchor in the yard to pull that wall back.
First thing we're going to do, dig out the foundation wall. We obviously have to dig out the foundation wall first to allow for movement of that wall.
And we're going to also dig a trench about 13 feet away.
I see we're transplanting the grass. Is that so that we can safely put it back?
Yeah, anytime we do excavations, we take the top layer of the sod and we put it to the side. And now we dig.
Looks like you're digging up more than dirt, huh?
Yeah, we ran into a lot of roots here. Apparently, there are a couple old trees that were cut down a few years ago.
You don't let that slow you down?
No, we're a problem-solving company. Just another problem for us to solve.
Look at this huge trench.
This is the trench we're going to be using for the wall plates. This is the exterior plate. This is going to go down into that trench. We're going to have that threaded rod come through the plate with a bolt. And then on the other side of that wall, there's another plate with another bolt.
Ooh, carbon fiber. Tough stuff.
The last thing we want to do is push this back and this doesn't move. These straps tie the wall together in one piece so that when we move this section comes with it as well. We're going to come back later and we're going to inject these cracks. So now we've got all our locations marked. Time to drill, baby, drill. The trench is 13 feet out. We have 2 7-foot sections of rods that'll have a coupler on them to make them 14 feet, and then we'll cut it down.
So that's 7 rods all the way through.
We got the rods through and we got the holes sealed so that no water is going to come through in the future. Towards the wall, we're going to be installing some shoring measures, and we're going to use these hydraulic jacks to lift that house and take the pressure off the wall.
It's time to move a wall. What are we using? A hydraulic press? Some big type of machinery?
Torque wrench.
You're kidding me.
We put a torque wrench on every single one of these plates, and all we have to do then is at the same time, turn, and this wall will start pulling back towards plumb.
Let's get cranking.
This is pretty close. You can even see how it's pulled away from the floor. We're within 1/2 inch, so I think this is the time for us to stop.
Look at how much that's moved now. That is amazing.
5.5 inches. We won. While the crew's outside backfilling, we're going to replace this I-beam support. We obviously don't want his house resting on this. So we've got a new one in here, and after that, all we've got, as you can hear, is the backfill.
Backfill party!
Yeah, buddy!
All right, so we got the wall straight and the backfill is complete.
You wouldn't even know a major excavation happened here.
You got it. And now these homeowners can go back to life as normal.
Real CO, taking the call to fix the wall.